Hi, it's Giffin LeBates here, and tonight I thought I would talk about the lending and borrowing of NFTs. So let's start with the first question, which is, what is the lending and borrowing of NFTs? Well, it's the idea that somebody owns an NFT, somebody else would like to have it in their possession for a period of time and is willing to therefore rent it off the owner. So then the second question would be, why would anybody want to rent an NFT? Now, in the current NFT world, if you wanted to rent a CryptoPunk, say, or a CryptoKitty, it might be because it's a famous token, you can't afford to own one, but you would like to have it in your possession to brag to people. So that doesn't sound like a very convincing reason. However, if you had a token that, for example, represented a very powerful weapon in a game, then suddenly it might become more reasonable. Somebody might be willing to rent out this super weapon for a fee, and players who've never had their hands on that particular weapon can pay a reasonable amount of money in order to get the NFT that then gives their character the weapon in the game. And then after they've run around shooting everybody, then they can hand it back and they haven't had to shell out the huge sum of money that it would cost to actually get their hands on that particular weapon. So that actually seems like a feasible reason to me to have NFT loans. But of course, at the moment, we don't actually seem to have much in the way of those kind of tokens, tokens with actual utility. But anyway, the reason why I'm making this post is because somebody pointed me at a project called reNFT, which provides a mechanism for doing exactly what I've been talking about. It allows people who own an NFT to transfer the ownership over to somebody else for a limited period of time and then get their NFT back and some rent for handing it over for that period of time. Except there is, of course, a problem on blockchains, which is if you give somebody a token, it's up to that person to actually return it to you. If they decide not to, there's not much you can do other than fine them and take them to court. And in the pseudo-anonymous, decentralized world of blockchain, that can be quite hard. So the reNFT guys have basically used the mechanism that loan protocols such as Compound and Aave use in order to secure loans, and that is they ask for over-collateralization. The lender and the renter come to an agreement that the renter will put up a hefty deposit for the token, which under the protocol should be significantly more than the market value of the token, and they put up all the rent in advance as well. Then the token, through a smart contract, is transferred to them, and at the end of the period, if they transfer it back, they get their deposit back. But if they don't give the token back, then the lender has lost their token, but they have the deposit instead. And so this only really works if the deposit is more than the actual cost of the token. So I can't really see that being very popular, because if you wanted to borrow a CryptoPunk that had sold on the market for 100,000 euros, you would need to be putting up collateral in the region of, say, 150,000 euros, and not many people have that kind of cash sitting around. And if you do have that cash sitting around, well, you might actually want to spend it on the token rather than renting it, but what do I know? Anyway, that's lending and borrowing of NFTs. I don't see in the current time how it's actually of any significance, but it's possible that at some point in the future it may become relevant, particularly given the example I gave of in-game tokens, and maybe there will be other things where tokens have utility where it would be desirable to rent them. But honestly, for the renting purely to have bragging rights, well, it doesn't really feel much like bragging rights. You know, the benefits you get socially of renting a flash sports car, for example, are pretty minimal compared to actually owning one and being able to show it off. But again, what do I know? That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this episode. See you in the next one soon. Bye for now.